sister. I know I haven't been around for a while, and I'm sorry about that. Sort of had another project going, and I was on a spiritual journey, which I made videos about, but like as I went. But in the end, I was wrong about all the past videos, and in the end, I had to ask Jesus to tell me what was going on, really, even if I couldn't tell other people. And I actually did make a video telling about it, which was a mistake. And I took it down, and I took all the other videos down. And so, I now have more time to do ASMR. Sorry for the absence. Silver Joker, because that Scientology guy said it keeps bad energies away. He said it would help with my anxiety for my thyroid. Anyway, I don't think it does. I was listening to that guy talk about, like, you know, how bad the Bible is, and everybody in the Bible was a lie, and I listened to him. I mean, I tried to listen to him. I tried to give him the benefit of the doubt, and he was so arrogant, and his personality was so grating, but I stuck it out for a while to, you know, to give it a listen, give him a fair chance. But anyways, in the end, I said, is this Scientology? And, a girl in the chat room said, sort of. I said, how can you be sort of Scientology? And she goes, Dianetics, which is freaking Scientology. But anyway, she says Dianetics. I said, so L. Ron Hubbard, Dianetics, I've read the book. And she goes, yes. And I sort of sat there for a minute or two, and then I just laughed. I didn't, you know, say, I think Dianetics was such a shite book. You know, I think I buried it in the backyard. I didn't say any of that. But I was thinking it. Yes, I was thinking it. Oh, my hair is such a wreck. So, I don't have to listen to him or give him the benefit of the doubt anymore. He was trying to convince me that Jesus was Patsy, and I'm like, you know, I tried to, he's like telling me to watch his videos, and I did, and he had no proof that Jesus was a bad scene. Oops. He had no proof that Jesus was a bad scene, and like, he's basically just telling people lies, and I don't know why, because he says he used to be a pastor for 25 years in the Christian religion. Now, I know the Christian religion has a whole lot of problems with false doctrine and stuff, and let's face it, none of us really know what the heck is going on. But, he didn't research in the right way, you know? He didn't research with, trust for Almighty God, which we all should have, you know. Even natives used to call it the Great Spirit. Everybody knows he's there. She, what, it, so wanting to leave that he threw the baby out with the bathwater, and he doesn't seem to care. And then he listened to people who were saying Jesus was bad. I don't know why. I don't know why he would do that. And then join Scientology. What happened there? You think that if you're a good person, everything else doesn't really matter, and I'm a great person. Really? I do not feel like a great person. I just did something where I told Jesus I wouldn't tell him that I told. That is the opposite of a great person. But, yeah. I do try, but I've always tried to be a good person. Things can always be taken in a different way, you know? Like, somebody can look at you do something good, and they'll think that you're, oh, just trying to look better than everybody else. You know, there's always two ways of looking at things. So, the road to hell is paved with good intentions. Fixed, and I don't think you jinxed it. Your yard is beautiful. It's beautiful, and I can't wait till you put up those trees that you showed me. And I know you can install the sprinkler system by yourself. You are an amazing woman. You probably have all the tools you need for it already. Oh, it's not great news about Sparky. It's just that my husband was giving him more Tylenol and stuff, so he wasn't moaning all night the way that he was in pain. But no, it's not great news. My husband is taking him in to have him euthanized on Saturday. I don't really want to talk about that, though. I'll start crying. Going to hairdresser. I used to love going to the hairdresser. I had a really, really good one. I could go in with whatever picture I wanted, grows at? How long you been growing it out? Inquiring minds want to know. Was it from bleach? I use super strong bleach, but I just cut out the damage every month. I love having buzzed hair. And now that I have all those wigs, wow. Whenever I don't feel like looking at bleach blonde pixie cut, just put one of them on. When is your big day? Don't forget to tell me. I want to be thinking about you that day and wishing you well. You need professional help. Me too, sister. Me too. You're sure Jesus wouldn't look down at me if I ever had a doubt? That's not his way. Yeah, you know, you're right. It's not his way. But there's some hints in the Bible that it's totally his way. But I trust Jesus. You know, the Jesus that I know more than I trust scripture. You know, it's a scripture. There's a verse in the Bible that says, the letter kills and the spirit gives life, but the spirit gives life. I'm not sure exactly what that means, but the Bible is like, it's a horror show, you know? And then you've got Jesus' sweetness, but in the middle of it. I don't know. My favorite scripture is, come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and humble of heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Isn't that the most beautiful thing you've ever heard? My yoke is easy and my burden's light. He also says that. I think I forgot to say it. It's my favorite verse and I always screw it up. Like, if you wanted to know anything from the Bible about what God is like, I would prefer it if the Bible was just that one verse with a name on who to call. But you know what? That went on with the Israelites and us is having a good time, and he's like laughing. I can feel it, you know. But it wasn't malicious or anything like that. He was laughing at me because I just found out what was going on, and because I'm heading for my glory of kingship. But yeah, you remember that movie Made in Manhattan with Jennifer Lopez and Ralph Fiennes? The security cameras in the basement of the hotel. Jennifer Lopez says, "I call you God. You know why? Because you see everything that's going on and you still smile." I thought that was cute. Yeah. I'm glad I know what's going on, but it kind of, you know, puts an end to me talking about God, because all the stuff that I knew or thought I knew before is wrong, and I don't have a peer group, even if I could tell what was going on. There's one guy that knows, kind of, but we're still not the same, because he's like, I'm of the Pauline gospel, right, the gospel to the nations, and he's Jesus when he walked the earth, which was to Israel. So I don't have one person in the world that I know of that I can talk to about what I believe. It's weird, but I feel okay. I mean, I feel good about it, because it got rid of a lot of torture. Religion is a bad scene. The religion's, you know, a bad scene. It's terrifying. Anyway. Yeah, more ASMR. I can wait for you. You waited for me. That I took. You know me, I have trouble making it to the end of courses, but I know a good course from a bad course. I bought a lot of courses in my day. You find my Jesus talk, and you found it interesting. Thank you. That's nice. A lot of people, you know, like atheists can really hate God because of the Old Testament, you know. But you weren't raised to know about God, so it is interesting. Thank you. You have a lot of weird experiences like me. Yeah. You should tell me about some of them. I would love to hear. Not Jesus coming to you. Or yourself, yeah. Or God, yeah. One of the scriptures about, it says that Jesus is the savior of the entire world. And then it says, especially to those who believe. Like, not everybody is meant to be, you know, in the body of Christ. For whatever reason. Not on this planet, anyway. Probably because, I don't know, it makes us weird and useless. Somebody's gotta bring home the bacon. I also have this Amiga energy type pendant on too. this impending World War III either. But I think that what we should be worrying about is inside of our own countries and everything turning to tyranny. Like, I'm Canadian, so what just happened here? Like, that's the government declaring civil war on its own citizens. That's tyranny. Anyway, yeah, I'm in a good mood. Mostly it's a thyroid problem. So I take this on Saturday, because that's going to be a bad day for me. Sad day. Sparky's going across the rainbow bridge.